with the real flow, signing out ES News, Andy Emilio, and why. He's here, he's in the house. I don't know, man. We might have to switch the name of it. It might be like a Macho Man Porter now or something, because I know you came with the whole WWE style. Yeah. People are still talking about it. They liked it. People liked it.
I mean, at the end of the night, I was like, mission accomplished. You know what I mean? I wanted two things to happen. I wanted to have some fun, and I just wanted people out there to be aware that, you know, a fight with myself and Danny Garcia is big and it's something that I want. Simple as that.
It immediately went viral. Everybody loved it. Do you feel like you got to do more? You got to keep that character going, man.
It's probably going to be something different. Believe it or not, I hadn't even seen a video or anything like that of Macho. I just was driving home, knew I wanted to do something, and he popped into my head. It's the craziest thing.
It's just instinctively, you know, you're from our generation. You're just like, that's the first wrestling voice you got in your head.
It's the craziest thing. Yeah, it's the craziest thing. And like I told everybody, I said, man, I did that in one take and just laid it down, you know. And moving forward, we'll try. This is a tough business, a very, very tough sport to compete in, to be at such a high level. And when you can have an opportunity to have some fun, take that opportunity. And that's basically all I'm doing now, man. Is I'm trying to enjoy every bit of this, of what I'm doing, and at the same time, you know, show everybody out there that I'm one of the best.
How was it when you put it out? Because I know you're more of like a laid back. You must have just like pressed the button. All right, it's out there.
Yeah,
and you just waited to get the feedback, right? Because I know I texted you. I was like, yo, that was hilarious.
So everything you saw me wearing, I have, right?
Okay.
As I'm collecting it to get it ready, this is when I start going like, oh, I don't want to do this. I said, forget it. You know what I mean? So after I did it, I waited for a minute. I was actually waiting now on my dad to see it.
Who filmed it?
Huh?
Who filmed it?
I had one of my guys back home.
Okay, all right.
Yeah, actually, one of my dad's new friends.
That was one take?
Leroy Thompson.
That was, I would have been too funny to do that in one take, man.
He said, when I was like, all right, that's it, he dropped it and he just bust out laughing. He said, I was trying my best not to shake. He didn't know what I was doing or nothing, you know what I mean? But we had fun with it, man. We'll see what's next. We'll see.
At the same time, you guys had some history, you and Danny. I think the weekend that he was supposed to fight Paulie up here, he said that you were tailor made for him.
Yeah.
Whatever happened, I know you and your pop came
through.
Exactly,
whatever happened. Whatever happened, exactly. That fight didn't never go away from me. It was something that another fight out there that I've always wanted. You know, I took a crack at Keith Thurman. I didn't get that one. You know, we're still waiting on the opportunity to fight him again. He had a crack at Keith, didn't get it done. It makes sense for him and I to fight now, you know, so that's it.
Seems like you're rolling with the punches, man, because I know after Birdo, you're supposed to be the mandatory for the WBC, but it seems like, you know what, you don't care. You're calling out Danny even for another, you know, mandatory, you know, but like...
Everybody's different, man. Yeah. I'm one of those fighters that I don't feel I need tune-ups. I don't feel I need, you know, get back fights and so on and so forth. I take what they give me, whatever they tell me to do. Now the WBC is saying that they want me to fight for the interim.
Okay.
They don't want their belt sitting around. I get that. I understand that. That's business. Who's out there is the next biggest name out there. And that is, at this point right now, Danny Garcia. So that's what we're aiming at.
There's two rumors. It's Danny Garcia on one side of the plate. Yeah. On the internet, they're saying Thomas Delorme on the Mayweather card.
I see the rumors too, man. And I asked my dad come here. I said, hey, what can we say? What can I, you know, my dad is saying they're supposed to give us the word tomorrow.
Okay.
So, we'll let everybody know.
All right.
So, live on Showtime tomorrow.
Okay, so big news could be coming. You might be on that McGregor card.
Showtime Sean Porter will definitely get back in the ring this year. I'm excited.
I knew something was up, man. You're looking way too in shape. Already ready. Good to go.
Yeah.
If you had to guess, what's more likely? You and Delorme on the McGregor Mayweather card, or you and Danny Garcia some other time?
You know what? Honestly, right now I don't know. They're telling me soon. So we cranked it up and we'll be ready to go.
Are you kind of going through what your dad always calls the fight before the fight right now? Are you tired of going through that?
Yes. You know, I'm not tired of it because I get it. So, I mean, yeah, I guess I can say I'm tired of it. I don't want to deal with it, but, you know, it's a part of the process. So, trust the process, you come out on top.
Let me ask you about your boy Adrian Broner, man. 138. That's like
my boy.
Super low, man. Hey, you know how we had to throw it out there a little bit. You know AB want to be friends with Kenny and everything.
It's hard, man. He makes it difficult to support him. He makes it difficult to wish him well.
balls because he's always talking, like in the Showtime interview.
You never know what's going to come back at you, you know what I mean? So I've tried to bite the bullet a few times and be the bigger man about the situation. Nevertheless, he's fighting tomorrow. Mikey Garcia, one of the hottest fighters out there right now. I feel it's a 50-50 fight.
Was that impressive, AB getting down to 138?
I don't know. Like, everybody was hooping and hollering like he won the fight.
Yeah.
I guess it is impressive because, you know, his work, you know, what his work ethic has been like in previous fights and, you know, him not doing everything required to be, you know, ready for the best. So, him getting down to 138, I think that is a sign that he is ready for this fight.
How did the weight look on him at 138?
It looked good. He actually worried me a little bit with all the bouncing around, you know what I mean? What's really going on, you know? So, nevertheless, though, he showed energy, which is what you want to see out of a fighter the day before the fight on the weigh-in. So, I think if anything, he was showing us good energy and trying to, you know, fill the room, you know. So, we'll see what happens tomorrow night, man.
AB's even said, you know, you can never tell when he's joking or not, but he's like, I could even go down to 35 if I wanted to. You know, it is. Yeah. You being a boxer, knowing how the weight works, is 38 close to 35, or is it still like so far away?
What, man? He contracted the weight at 44 when we fought. I know you know that. And as soon as I was told the contract was gonna be 44, I said, all right, and I just accepted it in my mind, and it was whatever. Getting down to 44, actually, believe it or not, was nothing.
Oh, wow.
But if I had to get down to 40, I don't know.
Okay,
so,
okay.
To lose another, you know, 5 pounds or whatever it may be, you never know.
There's a guy who's coming up to your division pretty soon, and I've seen some fantasy matchups on Instagram. Bud Crawford, yep.
Yeah.
It's coming up there. I mean, I even saw you guys take a picture with each other recently. When he comes into the welterweight division, is that somebody you got your eyes on? Because I know you like big fights, titles or not. You like big fights, big names, you know?
At this point in time, I don't know. And this is the only reason why I say I don't know is because I've never envisioned fighting him. So until he moves up, I can't really wrap my mind around fighting Terrence Crawford. I fought in the amateurs with him. I was 165, he was 132. You know what I mean? So it's like wow, like, you know, I get it. We grown men now and we gotta do what grown men do, you know. So we talked about it. And he said they want me to keep fighting at 40. I said, you ready to move up? He said, yeah, I'm ready whenever they tell me to, but they still want me at 40. I said, so who you looking at when you come up?
So you checked his temperature.
Oh yeah, okay. For sure. I said, so who you looking at when you come up? He said, the same guy you looking at.
Oh, all right, yeah.
I said, oh, so now we racing to fight this guy?
Yeah. Makes sense.
Yeah, he's a great person, a great athlete, a great fighter. And when he moves up to 147, and I believe it's gonna be a lot like 140 for him. He's gonna be able to compete with the best and entertain. You know what I mean? That's what he does.
Let me ask you this: why is everyone got the target on Keith Thurman, and Errol Spence just became champ, but not many people mention Spence as the guy that they want to get in the ring with?
I'm still targeting Keith. To me, right now, Keith is still that guy who is considered invincible.
Okay.
I guess right now, you know, no disrespect to Errol Spence, but he's just not viewed as invincible yet, you know? To me, you beat me, you did something, you know what I mean?
Yeah, yeah.
No matter how you got the decision or whatever, you know? So, I'm still gunning after Keith, too.
But the fact that no one's calling Spence out, doesn't that make you feel like maybe...
The fact that nobody's calling out Spence is just a testament to what they recognize, that he's a true champion.
After he just went overseas in that tough atmosphere.
He impressed me. He didn't impress my coach Wade, but he impressed me.
All right. There's a guy out there who has another belt, surprisingly, and you know, people are kind of like, everyone's chasing. As soon as he won the belt, Danny Garcia tweeted it. Yeah. So, Jeff Horn, how real? He seems to want you guys too.
Yeah.
He called out Keith, called out Spence, he's calling out the names.
That's like hitting the lotto, you know? It's like, what do I do now? What do I do now? And you want to buy this, you want to buy that, you
want to
buy this, you want to buy that, you know what I mean? I'm not saying he's not ready, but, you know what I mean, he just hit the lotto, you know? So, it's my understanding that he's going to have to rematch again with Manny Pacquiao. I think that fight's going to go a whole lot different. But, Yeah, man, he hit the lotto. So, I mean,
he got that kind of brawler style, too. That's a crazy style matchup with you and him to get him that ring.
I was looking at that, too. You know, I'm at the point now where I can't just fight a guy based on his name or his reputation or whatever. You got to take a look at all of it, not just how much money he's going to bring. How does the style matchup look? You know what I mean? So, I really did, man. I watched the fight. I was like, whoa, when he got the decision. But then I was like, that's a good fight for me, you know, so.
A lot of people are saying that Pacquiao should retire after that fight, you know, because seeing like a little bit of slippage, you know.
I wanted Manny to retire when he did retire. I think it's time, you know. Everybody has that boxing bug, you know, where you just can't let it go. It's something you've done for a long time, all this and that. I do believe he should have let it go a little while ago. Not because he's not capable, but just because, you know, I think his time is run. You know, I think he's run his course, you know. So I'm ready to do my thing and let everybody know that, you know, Manny's gone, but Showtime Sean Porter is here.
Thank you, guys, fellas. No, that was the last one, fellas. I'm about to shut him down.
Go ahead.
So what upcoming fights are you looking forward to?
No, we're supposed to make an announcement tomorrow night. They're telling me they're gonna get me on live on Showtime and tell me what to say. So I'm waiting. I'm excited too.
What about Cotto Mayaga?
I didn't hear about that.
Yeah, doing August 26th, the same line as Conor Floyd.
Oh, wow, I didn't even know about that. Oh. No.
What do you think about that fight? I think
Cotto's gonna get in there. He's gonna take it to Mayaga. He'll win that fight. Mayaga's not ready to fight.
What about the Triple G, Canelo? What do you feel about that?
More than that, that's fireworks.
Who you got?
You know, we say that a lot. That's fireworks. That's fireworks. I got Triple G.
All right.